Hello everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER. Today I want to talk to you about the wheel object in AppWizard. A wheel object is a great way to make a selection in a GUI, like these emoji here. But probably more common examples would be to select a date on a calendar or to select the hours and minutes on a clock. So let's assume we want to make a little calendar, and I already have two wheels on my calendar, one for the days and one for the month. And now I just need one more wheel so the user can select the year. And I already created a list for the years. As you can see over here. So all I need to do is select the wheel widget over here. And then bring it over into my calendar. Make it the right size. And maybe I want to call this wheel years. So let's start by selecting the text to be shown on the wheel. I can select that here. Here are the lists that I have defined, and I'm selecting the list with the years. And this is what we get. We're not quite there yet. I definitely need to enable endless mode, and I need to make my center cell size a bit smaller, like so. I also want the cells that are not selected to be in a slightly different color. So I can do that here. And then I'd like to highlight the center cells with a background color. Like so. Final adjustment here. And now we can try this out. And our calendar is complete. You can control how long the wheel spins before it stops right here. The default is 300 milliseconds, but if I would like to make the wheel spin for longer, for example, a full second, I can definitely control that here. As we saw earlier, it doesn't have to be just text. You can also select images to be shown on your wheel. And there's one more really important property you can turn on, which is the morph mode. So now that I have enabled the morph mode, let's check out what that looks like. So now when the wheel turns, you can see how the cells are kind of morphing into each other. Compared to if that's not enabled, it just stays constant. If we go back to our emoji wheel example, we can see that the horizontal wheels have the morph mode enabled. So you can see how the cells are kind of morphing into each other. While the vertical wheels don't have that mode enabled, so you don't have that same behavior. Here you can also see the use of images on the wheel, so I can select some images to be shown. And those will be shown on the cells in my wheel. There are a lot more settings you can also control down here in the properties. For example, the horizontal border, some overlays, the center frame size, and the center frame radius. And then the same for the outer cells as well. So you have complete control over what you would like your wheel to look like. As far as interactions go, there is a new job that was introduced together with the wheel. That is the move to job. And that job is used on the three horizontal wheels. So if any of the wheels change, that value is automatically moved to the three horizontal wheels. And we can definitely see that happening right here. These two vertical wheels also show the difference between the endless mode being on and off. So this upper one, the endless mode is enabled, so it just scrolls through. With the lower one, it stops at the top and it stops at the bottom. So in a nutshell, this is what I wanted to tell you about the new wheel object. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please also check out our other videos on AppWizard and other SEGGER software and tools. And thanks for watching.